Hi there. Well, this week's best buys are Smoketown portions, and they're just $4.39 a kilogram at both Safeway and at Sobeys. A bag of golden sugar is $2.49 at Superstore, and avocados are just 99 cents each at Co-op. Now, Thanksgiving is around the corner, and it's, you know, one of the really big grocery buys. People are in the grocery store trying to get ready for that big feast, and so it's a little crowded, but I'm going to be talking about all the great produce that you can buy. And then, of course, you can buy produce individually or you can buy it in bulk, but when you buy it in bulk, how do you store some of this, or how do you store some of this produce in general? But I just talked about avocados, and avocados are a little tricky because you may want to use it for a salad or guacamole, and either they're too hard or they're too soft. If you buy them a little on the hard side, if you have a little bit of advance notice and you want to speed up the ripening, put them into a paper bag along with some apples, and that'll speed things up. Now, when it comes to onions, quite often, you know, they come home like this. You put it into a plastic bag because they tend to be really messy with the dry skins. Then they stay in the bag, and then when you go in to get them, they're not very nice looking because they've gone bad. There's too much moisture in there. When you get them home, take them out of the plastic bag that they're in. The netting bag is great, but put it into something that the air can circulate in, such as a basket or something like that, in a cool, ventilated, dry area if possible. Now, when it comes to potatoes, these are potatoes just from my mom's garden, but you may want to get a massive bag of potatoes like the ones at Co-op this week. 15 pounds of red potatoes, great deal. But do you want to buy 15 pounds of potatoes to find out that they're for the composter, or do you want it to look like a, you know, it's growing all those roots like a mutant mouse? You don't want that. So store them properly. Again, much like the onions, in a well-ventilated, dry area, take them out of that bag. Even though the bag has holes in it, that's not enough to let the circulation and the moisture release. Now, potatoes and onions, they're good friends in hash browns, but don't store them together. The gases that they each give off will tend to make them rot faster. And make sure you have quality produce. If you get one rotten onion or potato, it's going to make the whole batch spoil. Now, when it comes to celery, buying it by the stick is a little expensive. So if you buy the stalk, wrap it into a paper towel, put it into a bag, it's going to store a lot longer. And same with apples. Keep them in a well-ventilated, dry area, refrigerated for 2 to 3 months. Take them out of the bag. And tomatoes, they like to be on the counter. So hopefully these are some of the tips that you can follow along, that you're not going to be, you know, getting those great savings. Be proactive. Don't throw your produce into the garbage. Save your money. Enjoy the holiday.